Hey everyone, I'm Dane from Moving2Canada, and in this video, I'm going to be explaining the Canadian Experience Class, or CEC, in 3 minutes. Understanding CEC could help you to stay in Canada and work for as long as you'd like. The CEC is an excellent immigration option for those of you who already have Canadian work experience. It allows you to apply for and be granted permanent resident status quickly and with relative ease. Plus, you can apply to bring your family with you. The CEC is a part of Canada's Express Entry Immigration System. This system is used to select new immigrants to come to Canada, and it's known for its very fast processing times. Successful applicants have their applications processed in a matter of months. But Express Entry is highly competitive. Initially, you have to meet the minimum eligibility requirements for your program of choice. In this case, that's the Canadian Experience class. Meeting the minimum eligibility requirements allows you to submit a profile to the Express Entry pool, but this does not guarantee your PR status. This is because all Express Entry candidates are ranked against one another using a points-based system known as the CRS score. Only the candidates with profiles who have the highest CRS scores will be invited to submit that official application for permanent resident status. Lucky for you, Canadian work experience is one of the most highly valued factors under the CRS. So, let's talk about the basic eligibility requirements for the CEC. But remember, these are just the minimum requirements. Express Entry is competitive, so if you can exceed these minimum requirements, you'll have an even greater chance of success. There are only two minimum requirements for CEC. First, work experience. You have to have a minimum of 12 months of full-time work experience that is skilled and was gained within Canada in the last 3 years. In order to be considered skilled, your work experience has to have been in an occupation at National Occupational Classification Skill Level 0 A or B. That's NOC code 0 A or B. The second eligibility requirement is language proficiency. You have to show that you are proficient in either English or French. If your work experience was claimed at NOC skill level 0 or A, then your language test scores have to be consistent with Canadian language benchmark of level 7 or CLB7. If your work experience was gained at NOC skill level B, then your language test scores have to be consistent with CLB5. If you meet the minimum eligibility requirements for CEC, you can then create your Express Entry profile. But remember, you need to have a competitive CRS score in order to be selected. One of the main factors in determining your CRS score is your level of education. So while education is not a minimum requirement for CEC, in order to be competitive under the CRS scoring system, you may want to claim your education. The CEC is a great option for those of you who are already in Canada working and want to extend your stay permanently. If you don't have any Canadian experience, I suggest you check out our video on the Federal Skilled Worker Program. This is another Express Entry aligned program, but it doesn't require any Canadian experience. And that's it for CEC. For more information about Express Entry, you can check out the link in the description of this video. And if you liked what you saw today, show us some love and make sure you hit that subscribe button. Thanks for tuning in.